It's morning at Meadow Glen. The seasons are changing. It's a brand new day. Coffee's on. Mary is polishing the brass. Emmanuel is decorating a room. Shavonda's making breakfast. Somebody new is moving in. And Managing Director Dick McClellan extends the same hospitality he learned on the family farm, the original Meadow Glen, 100 acres of woodlands and meadows, and family, where he grew up in Tennessee.
Well, I think the setting for today's Meadow Glen in Richmond was that we nestle against a park, and there are lots of familiar woods and trees that we had, the same kind of foliage that we had down in East Tennessee. We had an extended family. My grandparents were there, an uncle was there, and the doors were always open. There was always food to be enjoyed. There was always some time. There was time to sit on the porch. There was time to hear about what was going on with you. And so that southern hospitality, if you will, was something that just was ingrained from day one.
And so it's no accident at Richmond's Meadow Glen you'll find a porch and a patio, a comfortable sitting room and a media room, a large dining room, wide open spaces, places to walk, and places to visit with family and friends. The rooms are just right, carefully laid out to give you some room to stretch out and some places to put your favorite furniture. They're 350 square feet. A sunny window. Heat and air conditioning, you control yourself. A big closet. And a beautiful bathroom. Remember, Emmanuel was on his way to a decorating project?
He can do anything.
Yes, he can. The maintenance man even knows a little about hanging hats. And Sadie Kennedy says Emmanuel is a blessing.
I trust him. I trust his judgment.
They are so appreciative when you do what they want and do it right. Because, you know, all their life, just like us, they could do things by themselves at a certain time. And just because the years have gone by, and for one reason or the other, they are unable to do things, and they see that you're there to help them, oh, they appreciate it. And once you do it and do it right, the expression, the appreciation, all of it will just kick in, and it's just a happy thing to see. And it makes me happy.
Happy is also taking the Meadow Glen van for a shopping trip. Today, it's Walmart. And you can't beat this curb service. Pretty nice. Then, there's playing bingo with Dr. Mildred Fugman. She's sharp with a pencil. Doesn't miss much, and volunteers regularly to sort of keep an eye on things. She's a show-me person. Her mom's here, and she doesn't take chances.
Because she's my mother. It's the only one I have.
Mildred has made herself part of the woodwork and is satisfied they made the right choice.
If anyone is looking for that care for a family member, I can't see any reason why they wouldn't come here. I would not want a place that held 400 or 500 people. These people need more individual. They need to be recognized as people, as individuals, not as numbers. And I think this can provide it.
Jake Alvis found a new home too. He lived for 49 years in the same house, but when he and his daughter Sandra walked into Meadow Glen, he knew right away.
He walked through the door. This was the first place he looked at, and he said, "This is good. I want to be here." Uh-huh. So he's been happy here since day one.
Well, it's just the people are nice, and the staff are they're perfect.
It's home. It's basically it's home for Daddy, and that makes me feel good because he's happy, and if he's happy, I'm happy.
Flowers and friendships blossom at Meadow Glen. Mary Alvis and Ilma Nunley first met 60 years ago on a Model T school bus in Goochland County.
I was in the first grade at Sandy Hook's school, mm-hmm. and she was in the, I guess, 9th or 10th grade, and I thought she was the most beautiful thing I ever saw.
She fell from grace.
They had no idea each other was planning a move to Meadow Glen. Last time I heard them talking, they were planning a reunion in heaven. And in case you might have thought a retirement community is a place Santa might have forgotten, well, not here. Meadow Glen, as it turns out, is right down Santa Claus Lane. Do you ever really outgrow the jolly old elf? At Meadow Glen, whatever the season, there's a sense of fun and caring and of love that makes Santa inevitable.
The first time I walked through the doors here at Meadow Glen, it felt like home to me, and I know it feels like home to everyone who lives here.
The staff is second to none.
I'm most proud of our staff and our loving approach that we take to all of our residents.
I often feel like I have 48 grandparents here. You see it in the sparkle of their eyes, the touch of their hand, but usually it's just the small day-to-day things that let me know that we're connecting and it's working for them.
Not only are you addressing their healthcare issues, their medical needs, but you're also providing comfort to them on a personal level and just being that hand of comfort with them during times of need.
When I arrive every morning, I greet them right at 8 a.m. for breakfast. I meet with them personally, ask them how their evening was, and spend a little bit of time with them as they enjoy their breakfast during the morning. And then that gives me a chance to know how they're doing.
There is great wisdom that resides in our halls, and we just have to take a few minutes to talk to those individuals, to hear about their life, their wins and their losses, and each one of them has been gifted some way, and we try to allow that to re-blossom.
Lorraine Stewart is a new resident.
They had plays in the basement, and he must have been performing, because look, can you see the microphone? They had a pretend microphone. Yeah, that's still there.
She came here and we said, you know, do you want to look anywhere else? She said, no, I like it here.
Well, we tried to get all of her treasured possessions and bring a touch of home back into this room. And we think everything turned out just to look real nice and real homey. And she has the things that she's loved over the years right here with her. So we do think it's like a second home, and it's much closer to us too, so that's really nice. We can see her more often.
I'd say try it.
It's morning at Meadow Glen. Coffee's ready, and it's a brand new day. We are Meadow Glen of Richmond. Come see us.